Hello, everyone. My name is Mark Sandin, and I am the Title III Academic Language Coach here at Dimerly High School, and I'm representing the Multilingual Multicultural Education Department, and today we are going to talk about the constructive conversation skills. There are four of them, and for us to be effective with those and really get the most out of them, we're going to also talk about some conversation norms, and the goal here is to give you tools and some supports and some strategies so that you can boost your confidence, boost your understanding in the different subjects and different classes that you're taking, and, of course, boost your grades. So let's start off. I'll give you a brief overview of what the four constructive conversation skills are, and then I'll talk about the conversation norms. So we've got to start creating, right? That first skill is creating, where we're sharing ideas and we're coming up with original thoughts from ourselves that we're basing on prior knowledge. And we're also going to go ahead and use these conversation norms that I'm going to get into right now to listen to someone else's original ideas and validate those. So how do we do it? We learn something either via text, a lecture, or a video, or some other form, and then we're going to share those ideas with somebody else. So how do you make this constructive conversation effective? Well, we take into account thinking about using some of our think time. Okay? Take a breath. You've just learned something. Give you some processing time so that you can then share those ideas. You want to use the language of the discipline that you're going to be talking about. Your teacher's modeling that for you. I'm sure it was in either the video or the text or the textbook that you had just used as your source for this kind of conversation. So using that kind of academic language is going to be your goal. And then, of course, you're going to be with another person. It could be in a large classroom. So use your conversation voice. That means not too loud, not too low, right? You want your partner to be able to hear you, and you obviously want to be able to hear your partner without overwhelming the other person. And then, of course, we're going to be listening respectfully. We're going to show that respect to somebody else as they show that to us. And then think about what a conversation is, because we want to take turns in a conversation. So we do that, and we want to use this opportunity to build on each other's ideas. So back to the skills now. Once we keep in mind the conversation norms, use your think time, use the academic language, your conversation voice, listen respectfully, and then go back and forth building on one another's ideas. So we've got the creating, where you're coming up with your original ideas. Then there might be times in that kind of conversation where you might need to clarify, right? You might not understand fully what the other person is trying to communicate, or vice versa. So you use that opportunity to ask questions about, I didn't understand what you said. Can you please say it again? That kind of an idea, you're going to have to be able to recognize that. So in that process, you'll be getting prompt starters and prompt responses to help lead you through that process. So once you've done the clarifying, so you're for sure that you understand what the other person is saying and vice versa, you want to take that and fortify. You want to start to support your ideas, a lot like the survey where you're using textual evidence to support what your ideas and what your claims are. And then at that point, you'll go to the negotiating, which is really where we're building on each other's ideas. We're synthesizing, we're bringing together each other's ideas to really kind of challenge ourselves to say, is there something else, right, a new perspective that we can put into this conversation that might help build our learning? So once we do that, we've implemented those conversation norms. We've taken the ideas of what it is to create, to clarify, to fortify, and negotiate back and forth. Then at that point, we have these prompt starters and prompt responses to help us guide that whole conversation. Okay? Then we're going to look at one other thing. Okay? The idea of what it is to make a checklist. Am I doing all the things I need to do? Which is for me or my partner to acknowledge those other partners' ideas. Are we respecting those? Listening, paraphrasing, acknowledging that we've heard what they've said and we've understood it. And then in that conversation, can we take that understanding of what our partner has shared with us and can we build on those ideas? That's the whole goal. And then can we prompt a partner to clarify if we didn't understand something that they shared with us? And how can we fortify those ideas by using evidence that we are talking about what we have already learned? And can we use the academic language, those academic words that our teachers have modeled and what we've learned in that specific class or subject to convey our ideas, right? And how do we support that with evidence? And then again, this is the idea of taking conversation norms to really build a constructive conversation using those four skills that we've talked about today to take your academic achievement and take it to the next level. So I hope you've enjoyed this and learned something from it. Again, my name is Mark Sandin, and thank you for your time, and let's enjoy the next time.